Bonjour, Monsieur Maison Gauss.
No work for you today. How can I hire anybody when there isn't enough to keep me busy? People don't come to bakers anymore. No, they go to pastry cooks because it's stylish. Why don't you try the hospital? The man who was doing odd jobs moved to Tom's yesterday.
Merci, monsieur.
Take that stuff clear out to the dump at Marsabielle and burn every bit of it. It's full of infection and disease.
Why did Christ found the church?
Christ founded the church to teach, govern, sanctify, and save all men.
How long did Christ live on earth?
Christ lived on earth about 33 years and led a most holy life in poverty.
That is correct, except that you've omitted the last and most important word, in poverty and suffering. Never forget that, my child. For only through suffering can we hope to gain the kingdom of God. What is the Holy Trinity? I said, what is the Holy Trinity? Didn't you hear me?
Yes, sister, I heard you. But I know nothing about it.
Have you ever heard of it?
Maybe I've heard of it.
You puzzle me, my child. Are you pert, indifferent, or only stupid?
I'm stupid, sister. I have a poor head for study.
You're also pert. You're a grown girl, Bernadette. The oldest in the class. Ignorance of the Holy Trinity is inexcusable. Go to the foot of the class. What is it, Marie?
I just wanted to say that my sister Bernadette was sick the day the class learned about the Holy Trinity. She misses school a lot. She's always ailing.
What ails her?
They call it asthma or some such name.
You're trying to say asthma?
Yes, sister. That's what Dr. DeZoo calls it. She can't breathe. Sometimes she sounds just like this.
Laughter wastes valuable time. Return to your studies. Toinette, perhaps you can tell Bernadette what the Holy Trinity is.
The Holy Trinity is one God in three divine persons. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Ghost.
Sister Marie Therese, bonjour.
Bonjour, Father Pierre-Mel.
Bonjour, children. Bonjour. I was passing, so I thought I'd stop in, sister, and see how many children you were preparing for First Communion.
Six. We were just having a review of our catechism.
Well, you all know your catechism?
Yes, Your Reverence.
Learn your catechism requires great diligence. I believe such diligence should be rewarded. I have some holy pictures. Would you like one?
Oh, yes, Your Reverence.
Very well. Here you are.
Thank you, Your Reverence.
As you grow older,
thank you, Your Reverence.
You will realize that in learning your catechism,
thank you, Your Reverence.
Well, have given yourselves not only a foundation of religious teachings, but also a doctrine which will guide you as human beings throughout your lives.
I'm sorry, Father. The scale is not deserving. It would be unfair to the others. They have studied their catechism. She has not.
Well, that's too bad. I'm sorry. There should be an incentive to you, then. Study hard.
You found work. 20 sous. From the baker? Where then?
Don't ask me.
You didn't beg.
Worse. The stinking filth from the hospital had to be carted away and burned. That's the kind of job they give to Subaru. This is where they let him live. Subaru, the miller, made the finest flour in the scab. It was in a jail. It was too cold and damp for prisoners. It wasn't good enough for thieves and murderers, but for Subaru and his family, sure, let him live here. Let him freeze in the winter and roast in the summer. Let him get sick and die, who cares?
Come in, Jean. Maman Jeanne came along. She's going to help me with my studies later.
All right. There's always enough for one more. Sit down, all of you.
Oh, please don't, Marianne. I'm not a bit hungry. I'll just watch the others.
Your Father, Son, Holy Ghost. The one that eats fastest gets the most.
You're lying.
Where did you learn that?
You'll go to hell for saying such a thing. All I said, the one that eats the fastest gets the most, and it's true.
Now you've said it again.
I've seen pigs with better manners and cleaner faces. Get up from that table and go wash yourselves. Both of you.
Oh, a mass meeting here, How can anybody sleep with such racket?
We're sorry, Papa.
It's cold in here. Somebody fix the fire.
There's no wood.
So, I'm to get the wood, too. I work hard all day long. All I ask is a little peace and warmth. What do I get? Cold and chills. Must I do everything around here?
I'll go hunt for wood, Papa. May I go with Mary and help Mama?
No, you'll do no such thing. You know how easily you catch cold.
Mama.
I dress real warm.
Mama.
Please.
Mama.
All right, all right.
Mama.
Only wrap up good.
Mama. Can I go too?
No.
Oh, but please, Mama.
You'll stay in this house and spend the rest of the day asking God for forgiveness.
Louise.
What's wrong, Quasine?
It's the baby, the convulsions again. I don't know what to do. Help me, Louise.
Now be calm, Quasine. Go back. I'll be over in a minute.
Please, please, hurry. Come with me now, Louise.
Mama, can I go with you and look?
No. You stay here with your brother. You can ask for a little forgiveness, too. How about you girls back before dark?
Come on, Bernadette. Hurry up. The last one over the bridge is a goose.
Bernadette.
Good day, Madame Nicola.
Are your parents well?
Yes, very well, thank you. And how is your son, Monsieur Antoine?
Splendid, thank you. And, Mademoiselle Bernadette?
I'm well, thank you, Monsieur. Well, I'd better hurry on. My sister will wonder about me. May I use your bridge?
As often as you like, and no toll charge.
Thank you, Monsieur.
Here, you better let me help you. That bridge is not so dependable.
Thank you, Monsieur. You're very kind. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
She's growing into a fine young woman, isn't she?
There's a wood over there. Come on, follow me.
No way to cross.
That's private property over there.
What if it is?
If we take wood from there, we'll be stealing.
Wood is wood. Don't be such a fraidy cat.
Dad, I'm not a fraidy cat.
Yes, you are, too. Come on, Mommy, let's go.
Let's go! I'm sorry.
come in that water. Remember what Mama told you.
I won't catch cold.
Oh, won't you? You'll get a cough, then your asthma will keep me awake all night long.
Maybe I can jump across the rocks or something.
Yes, and tumble in.
And when you fall in and get your bottom wet, don't ask me to wring you out.
But if I dry my feet real well, I won't catch cold.
Oh, we don't need you anyway. Come on, Marie, let's go.
You stay there till we get back.
But three can carry more than two can.
This heavy bundle all the way back into town.
Bernadette! Yoo-hoo!
See? I told you she'd sneak off.
No, no. She wouldn't do that. She's here somewhere.
Has killed her.
Oh, nonsense. If she were dead, she'd be lying flat. Who ever heard of a dead person kneeling?
Then why doesn't she speak?
She's trying to be funny. I'll show her. Bernadette!
What's the matter?
What's the matter? That's what we're asking you.
I thought your asthma had killed you.
just stand there. Come on. You know we've got to get home before dark.
I'm coming.
We're not going to wade through that cold water again. You go down that side of the river and we'll meet you at the bridge.
What cheat you two are.
This water is as warm as dishwater.
You've got bats in your belfry. That water's freezing.
Well, it isn't now. Look, my toes are not even white.
What were you doing over there, kneeling in the rocks?
Didn't you see anyone?
Who?
Was somebody with you
in that cave?
Oh, somebody was. And you were praying for forgiveness.
John. Come on, tell us who it was.
Well, if I tell you, you must swear not to give me away. If Mamma should hear of it, she might take a stick to me.
I swear. I'll give you my word, but I won't swear.
Swearing like that's a mortal sin, and you don't want me to sin like that just before my first communion, do you?
Oh, come on, tell us.
Well, I saw a lady, and she was all in white.
A lady?
And she wore a blue girdle and had a golden rose on each foot. I've never seen anything in my life so beautiful.
Oh, Piff. What would a beautiful lady be doing in a filthy place like that?
I don't know. But she was there. Truly she was.
Come on, let's get away from here. You take that bundle.
No, I'll take this one. It's bigger and you must be tired.
His coachman was here, said there wouldn't be any more washing for you to do.
Where then is the food going to come from?
Don't ask me. I've been laying here worrying about that all afternoon.
Bernadette! Where have you been? I've been worried to death.
But we got wood, Mamma. 3 bundles. Enough for a day.
There are other things to be done besides getting wood. Sweeping and cleaning and water to be fetched.
I'll fetch the water, Mamma.
Just about at the end of my rope. Bernadette! Bernadette!
Dad.
Don't run!
It's cold tomorrow.
Good night, Marie.
Mamma, please take this.
There's no business running like that.
She ran all the way home. Couldn't even catch up to her.
She'd be coughing all night.
Bernadette's all excited because she says she saw a lady at Master Biel, all dressed in white with golden roses on her feet.
What on earth are you talking about?
That's what she told us.
Golden roses on her feet.
She said this lady was standing on a rock and smiled at her. She had a rosary of pearls and a golden crucifix.
Mary.
And a...
You told on me and you said you wouldn't.
Mamma, ask me.
What's this foolishness Mary tells me?
It's true, Mamma. In the cave at Massabiel, I saw a most beautiful lady.
A lady? What lady?
I don't know. Suddenly she was there, and then suddenly she disappeared.
Oh, nonsense.
Oh, no, Mamma, she was there. Her face was so beautiful. Just to look at her made me feel...
Sobiru, you hear what she says?
I heard, and I know why she says it, too. She's showing off, makes up a story to feel important. It always starts the same way with fairy tales. Golden roses on her feet, indeed.
No, Papa. I really and truly saw the lady. Truly, I did.
Come in!
for you, dear friend, for saving my baby today.
Compared to a child's life, it's not much, but we want you to have it.
Oh, no. No, I can't possibly.
It's the only way we have of repaying you. Please.
Yes, Louise. After all, if our friends are good enough to offer, then the least we can do is accept.
And you need the food as much as we do.
No, no. My aunt from Bigar came today with much more than this. We are merely sharing our good fortune with you.
May God bless you both. This is food enough for days.
Sausages like the kind in the butcher's window.
What a magnificent omelet those eggs will make.
Louis,
good to see you. What brings you here besides a cold rump?
You heard about Dutreloup?
The stableman for Cousin Al?
A horse kicked him and broke his leg.
The horse broke his leg?
No. Dutreloup broke his leg. Three places.
Oh, mercy, that is bad.
Oh, mercy, that is good.
Oh, shame on you, Louis.
I mean, it is bad for Dutreloup, but it's good for your husband. Cousin Alf offers you the job. That's why I'm here. It pays 2 francs a day and your lunch.
So be rude.
2 francs a day.
And the lunches are hot.
Papa, can I ride in the coach with you, please?
Me first. I'm older.
Well, you seem surprised. After all, it was agreed between Cousin Alf and myself that I should fill the first vacancy. But stableman... Well, I suppose even a miller can't be too choosy these days. You may tell Cousin Al that I accept.
He knows it. He wants you to be there at 5 o'clock in the morning.
Tears, Mama? Only because I'm so happy.
I'm happy, too. We must celebrate. You will all stay to dinner.
No, nonsense,
you will dine with us.
But tonight, Subiru, I hadn't planned.
So, we change our plans. We have food, I have a position. We accepted your eggs, now you must accept our omelet. I will not hear another word. Children, help your mother. A succulent omelet with sausages, Mama. Fix you some warm milk.
Thank you very much, but I don't need anything.
What was the matter? What happened?
The lady was there a long time, and she spoke to me.
She spoke to you? What did she say?
She said, "Will you render me the grace of coming here each day for 15 days?" And then she added, "I cannot promise to make you happy in this world, only in the next."
So after church, we asked Bernadette to come with us because we wanted to see if we could see the lady.
Well, did you see her?
Yes, no, none of us saw her. Bernadette said she...
Are you all right?
Yes, Mama. There's nothing to worry about.
Nothing to worry about? Scare me half to death that you say there's nothing to worry about. left your father's dinner to burn. I ran through the streets like a madwoman, and what do I find? You sitting there like a princess on a throne. You good for...
Don't strike the child. She's an angel of God.
Angel. The laughing stock of lords.
Come, Mama. Maybe we can get home before Papa does.
No. I won't budge from this place until you promise me never again to go to Masa Biel. Never.
But, Mama, I can't promise that. The lady has asked me to return every day for 15 days.
Promise your mother, Bernadette. Such excitement's bad for you. You're sure to be sick from it.
Very well. I promise you, Mama, never to go to Masa Biel again. Unless you yourself give me permission.
And that I can promise you, you'll never get. I'm going to send you to your Aunt Bernard and Bartray, where you'll forget this foolishness. I'm home with you. And you too.
Thank you for your kindness, Madame Nicolas. And thank you too, Monsieur.
What do you think of it all, Maman?
Things like that bode no good.
Maman, as long as I live, I'll never see anything more beautiful than the face of that girl as she lay there at Masa Biel. One ought not even touch a being like that.
Maman. Maman. Hmm?
What is it?
Bernadette's crying.
What's the matter, my lamb? Come to Mother, we'll sit by the fire.
You were so beautiful. Just to think of her makes me
there,
feel...
There, there, there. Girls of your age often see things that don't exist. But it passes. You must just put it out of your mind. You're a big girl now. Soon you'll be a woman. Marry a man and you'll have children. Just as I did. Life goes fast. My child. It's hard to believe how fast.
If she stays here, I fear for her health. She speaks to no one. She doesn't sleep. She doesn't eat enough to keep a bird alive. Bernard, couldn't you take her to live with you?
You don't know what it is to walk down the street and have everybody point you out as the father of that idiot. After all, I'm a respectable miller.
You are also the girl's father. And you seem to overlook the fact that you are her mother. The two people in the world who should be comforting and understanding. And you want to ship her off as if she were a sack of flour.
I'm thinking only...
Only of yourself. Bernadette is a simple, honest child. She hasn't the cunning to invent anything like this. She sees this lady. Nobody else does. Who are you to say that she is wrong and you are right? This lady may well be a heavenly creature.
Heavenly creatures don't appear in a filthy place like a city dump.
Christ was born in a stable. This is a wild story Bernadette tells. Since the lady has asked her to go to the grotto for 15 days, she must go.
Oh, I won't allow her to go again.
You will go with her. You can't hide your head in the sand and act as though your daughter were up to some harmless mischief that doesn't concern you. This is no joke. Consider what this means to Bernadette.
But what will people say?
Nothing. If you take your place by her side, all the women of the family must stand by her. I'll come. And when I walk with her, let anyone dare to laugh.
Has been put before the council and approved. So therefore, fully convinced that your request is justified, I am forwarding your plan as well as my recommendation to the Minister of the Interior, signed Baron Massey, Prefect. So you see, gentlemen, the ceaseless protestations of your mayor have borne fruit. The highest authorities are contemplating bringing the railroad to Lourdes.
Splendid.
Magnificent.
Commissioner.
What is it?
That Subiru girl, she just went to Massabielle again. What should I do?
I thought her mother had forbidden it.
But today her mother went with her.
To think that such a thing could happen in the middle of the 19th century.
Well, the girl's insane. Or suffering from hallucinations.
Your Honor, may I suggest that you act without delay?
But, monsieur, for the mayor, even to acknowledge the existence of such a situation would serve only to give it importance, an importance which the newspapers would not ignore. It's purely a matter for the imperial prosecutor.
No. Unfortunately, the state has no charges to prefer. It's up to the commissioner of police.
No one has broken any law. It's the duty of the district officer. Master Biel's in your district, isn't it?
Yes, commissioner.
Then take care of it.
People should come here.
Where is she? Is she here?
Oh, yes. She's standing there in the niche. She's greeting you now. See?
Down there. All of you, return to your homes immediately. Did you hear me? I said clear out.
This is hopeless. It's more than one policeman can handle.
Imagine these penny-a-liners having the audacity to print such a thing. All France will be laughing at us. And Lourdes was going to have a railroad connection. I'd even gone so far as to have the plans drawn up for the depot. Do you think they'll be granted to us now? Never. Who's going to run a railroad into a hole where spooks perform their medieval antics in dirty caverns? We are dealing with a whole lot more than the mere babbling of a little swindler or an imbecile. The entire future of this town is at stake. Something must be done to stop this nonsense immediately.
How?
How? Well, that's up to you and the prosecutor.
As much as I'd like to put an end to this stupidity, gentlemen, I'm helpless. The child goes peacefully to the outskirts of the city. There she kneels, says her rosary, and goes home again. Now tell me, is there anything unlawful in that?
Yes. On the ground that it's insulting to religious sensibilities.
Really?
Well, you can hardly call seeing the Blessed Virgin in a veritable cesspool complimentary to the Holy Family.
But that's just the point. She hasn't claimed to see the Blessed Virgin. The crowd claims that.
She says she sees a lady. A beautiful lady. And the visioning of a beautiful lady can hardly be construed as a violation of the criminal code.
It better not be, else the entire male population of France be spending most of its time behind bars.
This is hardly the moment for levity. Yes, 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 what is it? What is it?
Pardon me, sir, but Dr. Dezou is here to see you.
Ask the doctor to wait.
Just a moment. Dr. Dezou might be very helpful to us. Let's not overlook the vast possibilities offered by a diagnosis of insanity.
Yes. Ask the doctor to come in.
Yes, sir.
Will you please come in, doctor?
Thank you. Doctor. Ooh. Bonjour, monsieur. Bonjour.
Hello, doctor.
I'm sorry to interrupt, gentlemen, but I've made several visits to Marsabielle for the purpose of observation. Today I examined the girl. I thought you gentlemen might be interested in my report.
Yes, yes, of course. Won't you sit down, doctor?
Splendid, doctor. What did you find?
Well, I arrived at the grotto simultaneously with the crowd. Immediately, the Soubirous girl knelt in front of a niche on the side of the cliff, made a series of courteous, graceful, reverential gestures.
Did you see anything in this niche?
No.
Did anybody else?
No.
Well, then, didn't the crowd laugh at her?
No. There was something about her that precluded laughter. Her exaltation was so genuine that the observer almost had the impression that he saw what the child saw. Then as we continued to gaze at her, her face turned as pale as white marble, and her skin grew so taut the structure of the skull appeared clearly marked at the temples. Considering the possibility that this was due to cerebral anemia, I took her pulse. It was practically average. Also, there was no affection of the nervous system, as in catalepsy or hysteria. Even her eye reflexes were normal.
Did she speak to this thing in the niche?
Standing close beside her, I heard twice in succession a long drawn out yes. Yes. Wrung from her very depths. Evidently, she'd been asked to convey a message because shortly after she turned to the crowd and said, "Pray for all sinners."
Anyone who talks to something that isn't there is feeble-minded.
Another medical possibility which I took into consideration. Wanting to test her mental abilities, I put this question to her. Do you know what a sinner is? Without hesitation, she answered, "Certainly, monsieur. A sinner is one who loves evil." That's quite a good answer. What pleased me was that she said loves and not does. After this, any diagnosis of feeble-mindedness was out of the question.
Then she's a swindler.
There's not the slightest justification for such an assumption.
Then I must presume, dear doctor, that you have joined the ranks of the believers in this vision.
I am a doctor. I contribute to the medical courier. I'm a member of several scientific societies. I trust that is answer enough.
If I have correctly understood your report, doctor, it is this.
Science excludes fraud. It excludes mental disease and a miraculous occurrence. I venture then to ask science, what is left?
Yes. What is left?
If the church stops it, the people cannot blame us.
Precisely. We could sit back and sympathize with both sides. A very wise attitude for any government.
Is the dean at home?
Yes, monsieur.
Ah, good morning, gentlemen.
Good morning, Father.
Good morning. Come in. Take off your coats. I presume the Soubidou girl is what brings you here.
Yes.
I want you to know that the church attributes no religious significance whatsoever to the so-called visions of Massabielle. Sit down.
I'm very glad to hear that, Father.
Then you will talk with this girl, oh. And you...
Does not concern me. That is a matter for you city officials.
We had hoped you would cooperate with us.
That I am doing. Sit down. I have instructed the cantonal clergy not to set foot in the grotto, and to ignore the whole matter.
But your reverence has enormous power over the people here. Wouldn't it be appropriate for you to raise your voice?
I have no intention of adding further importance to this turmoil.
Then you force the state to invoke the law which prohibits the church from opening any new place of worship without the formal consent of the minister of worship.
The church has not opened any new place of worship. The church neither sponsors nor recognizes these daily heathen gymnastics which take place at Massabielle.
And how can you stand by and see your parishioners carry on these pagan ceremonies? I understand that they use a kitchen table as an altar, and there they pray. Yes, on a spot littered with filth, they pray to God.
Prayer, gentlemen, is good no matter where it is offered.
Yes, yes. Well, shall we be going?
Good morning,
Father. Good morning. That sly old fox, by agreeing with us, he's dumped the entire problem right back in our laps.
Unfortunately, the followers of the girl are citizens of this community. The thought of offending them is not very pleasant, especially with the election coming up.
Well, then why offend them? Why not refer the matter to higher authorities?
Very good suggestion, monsieur. I'll write to the prefect immediately. I consider it purely a local problem to be solved by local authorities, and I do not wish to be involved in any way whatsoever. Settle it without delay. The method I leave entirely in the capable hands of you and your associates. Signed, Baron Massy, Prefect. There he sits, like a general, safely out of the range of fire, and orders a handful of men without any weapons to wipe out an impregnable fortress.
Our capable hands. They're only capable when there's a ticklish job to be done.
To think that one stupid girl could cause all this trouble.
Only because there are millions of others just as stupid as she is. What can you expect from a peasantry fed on religious dogmas and nurtured on superstitious nonsense? I firmly believe that this girl and what she stands for is a menace to civilization.
The girl is dangerous, I admit, but
she's a religious fanatic. And every time religious fanaticism steps forward, mankind moves backward. And that is why I will fight this vigorously, and I'll resort to any measures to defeat it.
I don't know much about higher politics, but I do know a lot about burglars and thieves and scamps of all kinds. I know how to scare them and apply pressure. I promise you that if you give me 5 minutes for this girl, she'll never go near the grotto again.
Try it, by all means. Try anything.
I was thinking of somewhat the same procedure, however, not quite so crude. There's something about the title Imperial Prosecutor that makes people quake.
Without so much as raising my voice, I am confident.
You can't handle people like this with silk gloves and fancy words.
We shall see. Send for two of your policemen.
Dusty one.
You stay here, Mary, and wait for Maman to come home. Don't worry, or just tell her I've gone to the city hall with these gentlemen. What are you arresting her for?
Talking to her with the law.
The law? Death for the law.
Death for you. Madame Devine.
They're arresting Bernadette.
Madame Probert. Madame Probert. Look what those pigs are doing.
Do you know who I am?
Oh, yes, monsieur. You are the imperial prosecutor.
And that title means that I have been appointed by His Majesty the Emperor. He has vested in me the power to punish anyone who perpetrates a fraud against this community. Now, do you understand my position?
Oh, yes. You're much the same as Monsieur Jacquemet.
A good deal more. I am his superior officer. He hunts down the criminals and swindlers. I send them to prison.
Oh.
Now, bearing in mind my title and realizing the extent of my authority, I ask you never again to go to Massabielle.
Oh, but I must, monsieur. The lady has asked me.
Now, there you go again with this lady. Bernadette, you'll admit you are very ignorant, the worst pupil in the whole school.
That is true, monsieur. I'm very stupid.
Then you should take heed when intelligent people assure you that this lady is only a childish bit of imagination, an absurd dream.
The first time I saw the lady, I thought it was a dream, too.
There now. Now, that wasn't so stupid.
Once you can mistake a dream for something real, but not six times.
Isn't it strange that until your first visit to Massabielle, your family was destitute? Now your mother is employed by a wealthy family, and your father has a steady job, and your followers have literally showered your household with clothing and foodstuffs? Now, if the court were to decide that your lady represents a profitable business scheme, it would go very hard with you.
I have not accepted one thing, monsieur, because I knew the lady would not like it.
Look, my child, I am trying to help you.
He's using the wrong technique. He'll get nowhere.
I am not asking you to retract anything. I merely want you to promise me that you will accept my counsel.
If I can, monsieur, I will.
Good. Now, put your hand in mine and promise me that you will not go to the grotto again.
That I cannot promise, monsieur.
Let me remind you that I am the imperial prosecutor.
I know, monsieur. You told me that before.
Now listen carefully, Bernadette. In the next room is Jacquemet. He is cruel and mean. Furthermore, he believes that everyone should be treated like a criminal. If you refuse me, I will be forced to turn you over to him. I can promise you it will be horrible. He will have you cringing and crying in no time. But I can spare you all this if you will only be reasonable. Well, what is your answer?
It is the same, monsieur. I must keep my promise to the lady.
Very well. I'm finished with you. If you're intent upon your own destruction, go.
Yes, monsieur.
What's your name?
But you know my name, monsieur.
What's your name?
Soubert, Bernadette.
Before I go further, I want you to know I will write down everything you say. Such a paper is known as a deposition. It will be sent to the Imperial Prefect at Tarbes. Besides, we also have Monsieur Estrade for a witness. So be very careful what you say. Now, about this lady you claim to see, do you know who she is?
No, monsieur, I don't.
What does she wear?
A white veil with a blue girdle. And there's a rose on each foot. Mm.
She stands quite still, like a statue in church?
Oh, no, she's ever so natural. She moves about and talks to me. She greets the people and even laughs. Mm.
Do your parents believe this story of yours?
No, monsieur. I don't think they do.
And yet you expect me to believe when your own parents don't? If your lady were real, wouldn't other people see her too?
I don't see why they can. She's there.
Now pay attention. I'm going to read your answers back to you so you can confirm their correctness. Bernadette Subaru declares the lady wears a blue veil and white girdle.
No, a white veil and a blue girdle.
You're contradicting yourself. You said a white girdle.
You must have made a mistake in writing it down, monsieur.
Bernadette Subaru declares the lady resembles the statue of the Blessed Virgin in the parish church.
Oh, no, that's not true. The lady has nothing to do with the Blessed Virgin in the church.
That's enough. Nothing but a complete confession could save you now. Tell me the names of all persons who are in league with you. And don't try to lie, because I know every one of them.
I don't understand what you're saying, monsieur.
Well, I'll tell you. Certain persons have put you up to circulating this disgusting story. They've trained you, stupid as you are, to reel off by rote exactly what they taught you. Now tell me, who are these people?
But you said a moment ago, monsieur, you knew them.
The police are outside, waiting my orders to take you to jail. But if you promise before this witness that you will never set foot in Massabielle again...
No, I must keep my promise to the lady.
You want me to call the police?
If the police take me, I can't help it.
And that's not all. I'll have your mother and father thrown into jail, too. The rest of your family will starve. Come here! What the devil do you want?
My child. That's all I want. My child.
Listen, Subaru. This business at the grotto has got to stop. I won't stand it any longer.
So help me God, Commissioner. That's all I want, too. It's destroying my family.
The girl's a minor. You're responsible for her. Forbid her to go out except to school. Lock her up at home if you have to. Because if you don't, I'll lock up the whole bunch of you. Now get out. God help you if I have to summon you again.
Well, monsieur.
What do you think of it?
I think you were extremely fortunate in having the father break in just when he did.
The fact that the authorities have prevented her going from Massabielle has served to make her seem more important in the eyes of her schoolmates.
That is most unfortunate.
The children gather and whisper about nothing else. I'd hope, Father, with your permission, to talk to them and show them that...
The Bishop of Tarbes has forbidden us even to recognize the situation. And he's right in doing so. Do you remember that girl in Avignon, Rose Tamizier? She claimed to have seen the Most Blessed Virgin also. The vicar general of that diocese was patient and understanding. Consequently, the people mistook his attitude for approbation. Then later, when the child was exposed as a fraud, the church was looked upon as her partner in crime. Immediately, atheism flared up, and the anti-clerical forces triumphed. That is not going to happen here.
What I had in mind, Father, could hardly be construed as approbation. I had planned to make an example of this child in front of the class.
Ridicule?
Yes, Father.
You have my permission to try it. Good day, sister.
Good day, Father. Thank you.
She can't go on like this.
night after night.
My poor little one. What have they done to you? Speak to me.
If I can't go see her anymore, I shall die.
You shall see her. I don't care what Sister Fazou said. You'll go again to Masabiel, and no one will prevent you. And if they lock me up, madam, you shall see her.
I hope their old Massey subscribes to this paper.
Sounds a little different from the last editorial, doesn't it? Listen to this. The officials at Lourdes are to be highly commended for stamping out these disgusting spectacles.
But I have a feeling they will return to criticism again tomorrow.
Well, what makes you think that?
Because I am a man of greater vision than you, Monsieur le Maire.
Mm-hmm.
Especially when I sit in this particular chair.
I told them if they did this again, I'd put every one of them in jail.
Careful, Commissioner. If you do that, I'll have to release them in 10 minutes. And then we would look foolish, wouldn't we?
There must be some law to stop them.
Commissioner. I know. They're going to Massabielle. You don't have to tell me. I've got eyes. I can see.
No, they're not going to Massabielle.
They're not?
They've already been. They were there at 5 o'clock this morning. They're on their way now to the dean.
The dean?
Yes, the girl said the lady gave her a message for him.
Well, it seems the gods have finally sided with us. Gentlemen, maybe now the church will be forced to take a stand, whether it wants to or not.
Excuse me, Your Reverence.
What do you want? Who are you?
Bernadette Soubirous.
Oh, so you're the urchin every idiot in France is talking about. Do your courtiers and servants always follow you? If any of that crowd dare to enter my garden, I'll have them arrested. Well, speak. What do you want of me?
The lady told me.
What lady?
The lady of Massabielle.
Don't know her.
She's a beautiful lady who always comes to me.
Is she from Lourdes?
No, Your Reverence.
Have you asked her name?
Yes, but she gives no answer.
Perhaps the lady is deaf and dumb.
Oh, no, she speaks to me.
What does she say?
Just now the lady said, please go to the priests and tell them a chapel is to be built here.
Priests? What does that mean? It appears your lady is a confirmed heathen. The very cannibals have priests. We Catholics have religious, each bearing a specific title.
But the lady did say priests.
Well, you've come to the wrong place, anyhow. Have you any money with which to build a chapel?
Oh, no, I have no money at all.
Then you go back and tell your lady that if she wants a chapel, she'll have to provide the money.
Yes, Your Reverence.
And you can also tell her that the Dean of Lourdes doesn't consider it very fitting for a lady to climb barefoot on rocks and to send gibbering adolescents with messages. And what's more, once and for all, he demands that she leave him in peace. Do you understand?
Yes, Your Reverence. I'll tell her.
Just one moment. Do you see this broom?
Yes, Your Reverence.
Then listen carefully. If you dare to annoy me ever again, I'll take this broom and with my own hands I'll...
Come in.
something, Your Reverence. The lady also said, let processions come hither.
Processions, eh? And do you think tomorrow would be soon enough for your lady?
Oh, yes, I'm sure she would be delighted. Now that I've given you the messages, I'll...
One moment. I'll decide when you're to go. Close the door.
I want you to convey a message to your lady for me. You find her quite extraordinary, don't you? Extraordinary she is. I have heard that there's a wild rose bush growing in the grotto. Is that true?
Oh, yes. Right under the niche where the lady always stands.
Splendid. I want you to tell the lady this.
The Dean of Lourdes would like her to perform a little miracle. He would like her to make the wild rose bush bloom. Now, this last week in February. You understand?
Yes, Your Reverence.
Then repeat what I said.
The Dean of Lourdes would like the lady to perform a little miracle, to make the wild rose bush bloom now, this last week in February. Is that correct?
Yes.
I'll tell the lady. Good day, Your Reverence.
Gentlemen, I'm off to see the miracle.
Bring me back a dozen roses, will you please?
I rather think I'll bring you back 100 dozen disillusioned people.
Deneen said no definite time. Why do you assume that today's the day?
We don't. Our followers did that. It shall be on Thursday, they said.
Why Thursday?
Because someone who had nothing better to do figured out that she first saw the lady on a Thursday. The lady returned to her on a Thursday, so naturally the bud shall burst on a Thursday.
Buds or no buds, you will never destroy that girl's faith.
Can you say the same of the crowd?
Wouldn't we be surprised if the bush did bloom today? Don't underestimate the Dean of Lourdes. Who is the best authority on roses in this district?
Paramal. The weather too, for that matter.
Do you mean that you think the Dean...
I merely think it is singularly strange that Perimal, of all people, picks a rose bush of all things to demonstrate a miracle. Why didn't he ask the lady to make the rock into a white horse or change the river water into wine?
Anything yet?
No.
And nothing will happen.
Shh.
Quiet. Keep still. It's no use, I tell you. The bush will not bloom.
Shh. You keep quiet.
All right. But you will see. Life is not like that.
I don't see something, do you?
Spring. Drink of the water and wash there. No, not the river. Not the river? The spring yonder. Eat of the plants.
Eat of the plants.
What's she doing now?
Shh. Drink of the spring and wash there.
To the spring? Drink of the water and wash myself?
What is she looking for?
She uses her nose like a pig.
Yes, and she roots up the ground.
Wash myself in the spring.
There's
the
no
lady is asking.
Spring here, Bernard.
There is. There is. The lady said so.
Come.
At last, you've seen with your own eyes what we officials have known all along. That this story of the Blessed Virgin was born in a sick and warped mind. You've been duped by an idiot. I beg of you, go back to your homes and never return here again.
Be sad, Antoine. I told you not to hope too much. I knew it would not bloom. You must learn to expect nothing from God. When you get nothing, you will not be disappointed.
Keep still. Go away and let me alone.
From the time we are knee-high, they tell us the Blessed Virgin is loving and good. Was she good to that girl just now? Was she good to me? Me, Bourriette, the finest stone carver in Lourdes. I'll never forget that day. I was carving a statue for the church. A chip of marble flew off my chisel and hit me in the eye. And as quick as that, I was no longer a stonecutter. And that's how the Blessed Virgin repaid me, by throwing a stone in my eye. Ever since, it's been like looking through a bowl of milk.
Don't be in such a hurry with your miracles, will you? Tomorrow at 2, Madame Blanc. Come here. Yeah. Sit down.
Yes, Doctor.
Fix your eye on the ceiling and look straight ahead.
Yes. All I did was put mud on them from the grotto.
Be quiet.
And then I said a prayer, and now I can see.
Quiet.
It's a miracle, Doctor. It's a miracle.
Still. There's no improvement in this eye, Boyette. 4 scars on the cornea.
Same as it was 6 months ago.
But I can see. It's like sheet lightning.
Excuse me.
Doctor, everything is bright.
What you've done is pressed against the eyeball so hard, you've irritated the optic nerve. For a time, things will seem bright, but that'll pass. Take a look at that chart.
Yes.
Can you read it with your left eye?
No, Doctor, I can't.
How about the right?
No, I can't.
How about both eyes?
No good, Doctor.
There you are.
But, Doctor, I never knew how to read. But I can see. I can see you, Doctor. I can see everything. It's a miracle.
Come back tomorrow when you're calmer, Boyette.
All right, but it's a miracle. It's a miracle. It's a miracle.
I understand it all now. Ever since that piece of marble flew in my eye, she's been trying to find a way to make it up to me. And at last she did.
Mortar, you can see better now, Boyette?
I see everything.
Get Louise Soubirous. She has always saved him before.
She's not at home. I can't find her.
It's too late.
It's better so. You don't want your child to drag himself through life a hopeless cripple, do you?
I want my child to live. No! No!
Come back!
Somebody's coming.
Marcin,
who is it?
Where? I don't see anything.
Marcin!
Marcin!
Marcin, please.
What a move.
Marcin, be sensible.
I can be.
Are you mad?
Take him, oh Lord, or give him back to me.
Be no question of innovation. I can find no reason to doubt the presence of muscular substance.
What does that mean, Doctor?
That means that yesterday the baby's legs were completely paralyzed, and today they're as sound as yours. I'm sure you can understand now my anxiety for confirmation of my findings.
You're positive there's not a possibility of error in your previous diagnosis?
August 25th. High temperature, violent convulsions, complete paralysis of the legs.
Couldn't we assume a mere atrophy due to rickets?
I couldn't.
Then the water at Masebio must contain an unknown and powerful therapeutic substance.
At any rate, I must report on this case to the medical journals.
I'd hesitate to do that. It might make you an object of ridicule.
It won't be an easy thing to write. I'm not accustomed to believing things I can't see. What about you, Father? You've been very silent. What do you make of all this?
Well, unlike a doctor, a religious must believe a great many things he cannot see. Sometimes, I confess, it's extremely difficult. Last night when I came here, it was very dark. It's much lighter now. Good morning, gentlemen.
And no longer are his legs like dish rags. Now they're firm and strong. And without Bernadette, it couldn't have been. Let me say a prayer by her bedside.
Heavenly Father, no. Save your prayers for Mass. Now go home to your wife, Charles.
Tonight you will all have dinner with us. We will have an omelette 10 feet wide.
Mama. Good morning, Papa.
Good morning, Bernadette.
Good morning, Bernadette. Cold water, and all of a sudden the baby began to cry. Not a weak, sickly cry, but a healthy one.
And both doctors agree a great change took place. They confess they can't understand it.
It's left them wondering. What do you think of it, Father?
I, too, am wondering.
And you know the baby was never strong enough to cry before. Then, on the way home, the child went asleep in his mother's arms.
When he woke up, he was smiling and hungry. Blankets began to stir. He was moving his legs.
Almost since he was born, his legs were as if they had no muscles. The doctors couldn't move them.
Yes, Commissioner. Sunrise, that whole hillside will look like a sugarloaf crawling with ants.
Oh, it won't be so bad after tomorrow.
Why?
Well, she said the lady only asked her to come for 15 times. Tomorrow makes 50.
But this is no longer a curiosity. It's a disease. This card will come whether she's here or not.
Where do you think you're going?
No place, monsieur.
What have you got in that basket?
Commissioner, my wife is very sick.
Have you got your wife in the basket?
No, monsieur.
Let's see. What's in it?
Oh, monsieur, I thought maybe I could sell some hot chestnuts and some wine.
There we are. Now it's started.
Pretty soon they'll be selling sausages.
You want sausage? I've got sausage, too.
No. Go. Move.
Must have a name. Didn't you ask her name? I've told you to time and time again. And now it's too late.
I did ask her today.
Well?
What she said, I didn't understand.
Well, speak. What was it? You haven't forgotten.
Oh, no. I repeated it many times so I wouldn't forget. She said, I am the Immaculate Conception.
Immaculate Conception. Do you know what it means? I am the Immaculate Conception. Don't be afraid, my child. I sent for you to help you, not to scold you. Well?
No, Your Reverence. I do not know what it means.
Do you know the meaning of the word immaculate?
Yes, I know that. An immaculate thing is clean.
Good. And conception? Well, we'll leave that for the moment. Do you know what we mean when we speak of the original sin?
Yes. The original sin was committed by Adam and Eve when they did not remain faithful to God, but broke his command.
Father Pumian taught you that, didn't he? Now think hard. Didn't he also speak of the Immaculate Conception?
No, Father, I never mentioned that dogma. It doesn't belong to the pedagogic material of the elementary class.
Perhaps Sister Vosu discussed it.
I'm sure she didn't.
Well, you must have heard the expression somewhere. I'll try to remember.
Maybe I've heard about it, but I don't remember.
Very well. I'll try to explain it. The Most Blessed Virgin Mary was preserved free from all stain of original sin, even from the first instant of her presence in her mother's womb. God did this for her because she was to be the mother of Jesus Christ. A most singular privilege of grace. Do you understand that, Bernadette?
No, Your Reverence.
Why should you? Great scholars have racked their brains about it for centuries. But perhaps you can grasp this one thing. If the Most Blessed Virgin were to speak, she could not say of herself, "I am the Immaculate Conception." All she could say would be, "I am the fruit of the Immaculate Conception." Birth and conception are events, but a person is not an event. You can't say, "I am conception. I am birth." Consequently, your lady is guilty of an inexcusable blunder. You must admit that.
So next time I see her, I will tell her, Your Reverence.
Excuse me, Father. I promised to look in on Madame Sinax.
Certainly.
Goodbye, Bernadette.
Goodbye, Father.
What am I to do with you, Bernadette? Your eyes seem honest, your words sincere. Yet I cannot believe you. Today, less than ever. As your confessor, I beseech you, renounce this falsehood. Confess that your mother, or your father, or your aunt, or someone suggested that phrase that you might become important in men's eyes.
But I can't confess that. It isn't true. No one suggested anything to me.
Have you ever thought about your life and what your future would be like?
Like the future of all the girls hereabout.
After First Communion, girls may indulge in proper pleasures. They go to dances at the festivals, meet young men. And after a time, please God, they marry and have children. Wouldn't you like to be such a girl?
Oh, yes. I'd like to go to dances. Have a husband someday.
Then wake up! Now! Otherwise, life is at an end for you. You are playing with fire, Bernadette.
Commissioner.
Yeah?
That spring at the grotto, the people are drinking quite a bit of that water, aren't they?
By the bucketful. What they don't drink, they carry away in pots and pans and bottles.
That's good.
Well, they're still at it. You thought it was bad before. You ought to take a look at it now. Sick, lame, canes, crutches. Some of them even look like lepers.
Listen to this, Commissioner. December 22nd, 1789. All waters contained in springs, wells, streams, rivers, or any other source whatsoever shall not be consumed by anyone whosoever until the aforementioned waters have been thoroughly analyzed by a registered chemist.
That's perfect.
You know, I had a feeling that somewhere in all these books I'd find one old law that'd suit our purpose.
Shall I send my men out to close the grotto now?
No, not so fast, Commissioner. First, we'll take this to the mayor, and he will issue a proclamation.
Come in.
Come in, gentlemen.
Thank you. I have good news, Monsieur le Maire. The Holocaust will spread no more. I have found a way to stop it.
Our troubles are over.
And ironically enough, it's the waters of Massabielle that will quench this fire. It's an old law, 1789. Look there, read it.
In the interest of public health.
Of course, for such an important analysis, we'll have to have the opinions of many chemists. And that might take months and months and months.
I wonder if we're not being a little too hasty in this. Perhaps we're short-sighted in dismissing the possibility of divine power in regard to Massabielle. For after all, I'm sure that you gentlemen, as well as I, do not want to oppose the will of God.
Your sudden religious fervor is most touching, Your Honor. Could it be prompted by the fact that the devout masses have brought with them a wave of prosperity to Lourdes?
Monsieur. But now that you mention it, we shouldn't overlook that either. Our hotels are filled, our cafes are crowded, and our shopkeepers have never known such business.
And the railroad is sure to take advantage of this influx of visitors to Lourdes and extend its line here to Lourdes.
Yes, yes, and in that case we shall need more hotels. But aside from all that, I'm thinking mainly of the thousands of pilgrims who come here daily with hope in their hearts. If they derive any benefit from the water, Massabielle, who are we to deprive them of it? Then to think of the vast number who cannot come to Lourdes. For them we could bottle the miraculous water, and it could be sold at a nominal fee all over the world.
Your Honor, will you dictate the proclamation to close the grotto, or would you rather that I contact Baron Massy and ask for permission to do it myself?
Very well, I'll do it. But I think you gentlemen are making a big mistake. Now, why not think it over for a time? Courage, take a proclamation.
Commissioner, any trouble?
Oh, no. We finally wiped out this epidemic.
No, Commissioner. To wipe out an epidemic, you must eliminate the cause.
I left the grotto patrols night and day. Nothing can happen now.
Perhaps nothing can happen at the grotto. However, since the lady is merely a figment of Bernadette's imagination, she can see her any place. Beside the river, in the harbor where she lives, or if she wishes, on the very steps of the city hall.
Huh?
The next fence we build must be around her imagination. Have you ever heard of Dr. DeVoe?
Yes.
I've just written him asking him to come to Lourdes for a few days.
Just a moment. Come along. The Imperial Prosecutor wants to see you.
You can't take her. She's done nothing.
Come on.
I'll go, Maman. Don't worry. It won't be long.
Look, why must you keep plaguing her? She's tired and ill. Leave her alone!
Please. I never felt that Dr. Duzou's examination of the girl was extensive enough.
Well, after all, Dr. Duzou is a general practitioner. The advances in psychiatry have been so rapid that only a specialist could hope to keep up with them.
Do you think the girl is insane, monsieur?
My dear doctor, I am a great respecter of medical science. Therefore, I think that as a layman, I am not qualified to have an opinion. However, I do think that the bare facts of the case should be permitted to speak for themselves. Day after day, she stood before a hole in a rock and conversed with the Blessed Virgin.
Such delusions are a usual symptom of paranoia. I have many paranoics in my clinic who claim visions, oftentimes followed by a tendency towards violence. Has this girl been allowed to come and go as she pleases?
Well, I had planned to put her under restraint, but of course Dr. Duzu's favorable diagnosis made that impossible. I trust that your examination, Doctor, will not be a cursory one.
I can assure you it will be most extensive. It may even be necessary to place the child in an institution under observation. And unfortunately, with paranoics, observation sometimes takes a long time. After all, a psychiatrist is not an orthopedic surgeon who can set a broken bone on the spot.
Yes, 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 I understand. Come in.
Eyes closed. Now the other foot. Why are you so unsteady?
Because I'm very tired, monsieur.
All right. You may sit down now. How many hours in the day?
24.
How many days in the week?
7.
How much is 7 times 5?
35.
How much is 17 times 18?
Do not know, monsieur.
Oh.
Would you know the answer, monsieur, if you hadn't figured it out before?
Not so fast, young lady.
Oh, don't bother. She'll go directly home. We can take her from there. Here we are, Doctor. Father Perimeo.
Have I the honor of addressing the Dean of Lourdes?
You have that honor. How can I serve you?
Hadn't we better go elsewhere and discuss this matter?
It is you gentlemen who have chosen this place of action, not I. What do you want here?
I'm here on behalf of the medical department of the provincial administration. There are evidences of definite anomalies in this girl, Bernadette, and I wish to place her under observation. I'm a professor of psychiatry and neurology at the clinic of Tarbes.
If the girl does not willingly submit to this examination, we will be placed in the unfortunate position of being forced to invoke the law of 1838.
This is the most shameless piece of hypocrisy I have ever encountered. I warn you, I shall expose this hypocrisy. And I shall raise such a voice throughout all France. The reverberations will send petty politicians toppling from their seats. Come here, Bernadette. I know this child. So does the Imperial Prosecutor. She is neither a maniac nor a menace to her fellow men. If you still intend to take her, gentlemen, well and good. But rest assured, I shall not stir from this girl's side. Now, call the police.
And when the police do come, what then, Your Reverence?
When they come, I shall say to them, load well your guns, for your path lies over my dead body. Well? Come,
Superiors asked me to watch over you.
I'm sorry to have caused you this trouble.
I welcome the opportunity of talking to you before I leave Lourdes.
You're leaving?
Tomorrow. I've been recalled to the mother house of our Order of Nevers. The Dean of Lourdes is on his way to speak to the Bishop of Tarbes in your behalf. I want you to know that although you have used your wiles successfully on a great many people, there is one person remains who does not believe you. that person is myself.
I never wanted you to believe me, sister.
If that is one of those disarming answers of yours that is supposed to strike one silent, you need not waste it on me. You should be thankful, Bernadette, who did not live in former times. Creatures who boasted of equivocal visions and produced springs as if by magic were burned at the stake. I have prayed for you night after night, and I shall continue, so that your soul may not be destroyed by the frightful danger to which you are exposing it. And now, good night, Bernadette.
Good night, sister.
However, above all that, I come in the cause of justice. The authorities are scheming and plotting this girl's destruction.
It is not the practice of the church to interfere with the authorities. And particularly in the case of Bernadette Soubirous, we will rigidly adhere to our policy of remaining aloof.
In my opinion, a change in our policy is now necessary.
That opinion is not shared by an amazing number of equally worthy ecclesiastics.
I realize that. I also realize that none but myself has talked to this child. I've begun to wonder if she is not a true vessel of grace and a worker of miracles.
No, stop. My dear Dean, only the congregation of rites can determine whether a given phenomenon is a genuine miracle or a deception.
True. That's all I ask. An Episcopal commission be set up to investigate.
Two or three questionable cures are not sufficient to cause an investigation.
One questionable cure was sufficient to cause a multitude to travel hundreds of miles.
Very well. I will convoke such a commission.
Thank you.
Providing certain obstacles can be surmounted. You fully realize, of course, just what this will mean. The commission can render only one of three decisions. First, you're an imposter, little Soubirous. Hence, away with you to a prison for juvenile delinquents. Second, you're a madwoman, little Soubirous. Away with you to an asylum. Third...
You are the rarest of mortal beings, little Soubirous. Just when do you think the commission will begin its work?
The scientists, the chemists, the geologists cannot possibly conduct their researches with the grotto boarded up.
A letter from you will force them to open it.
No. The emperor must command that the grotto be opened. Then the commission may assemble, not the other way around.
When will you ask the emperor?
Never. I've not the slightest intention of mentioning it. You will not know that I even contemplate convoking the commission. My attitude puzzled you, doesn't it?
Frankly, yes.
I'm giving your lady a chance to prove herself to me. If she is the Blessed Virgin, then nothing is impossible for her, and she will overcome the Emperor. However, if she is overcome, then she's a fraud. The grotto will remain boarded up, and she and any thought of the commission will vanish into thin air. I wonder, my dear Dean, who will win? The Emperor or the lady?
Stay where you are! You're under arrest. They go down. I'll watch them from here.
Name, age, occupation?
Shop Rousseau, 46, carpenter.
Charge?
Stealing water from Massagil.
1 franc and costs.
But I haven't got it, monsieur.
2 days in jail, then. Take him away. Next case.
Where are you? Woman.
Mother! Woman!
Sorry.
Name, age, and occupation.
Ria Leontine, 34, governess.
Commissioner. Brewer, madame, are you by any chance related to Admiral Brewer?
He's my husband.
Oh, I am Vital Dutour, the Imperial Prosecutor.
How do you do?
Won't you come into my office and sit down, please?
I was arrested and led through the streets the same as the rest. I do not wish to be treated differently now that I'm here.
Madame, this is most distressing. You are the bearer of a great name. When ladies of your station exhibit to the masses their utter contempt for the law by breaking it, what is the poor civil servant to do?
Punish them the same as you would the others.
Very well, madame. I am forced to require you to pay a fine of 1 franc and cost.
Delighted, monsieur. And here are 100 more for my fellow criminals who are without funds. And now, please, may I have the bottle?
The bottle is confiscated.
But I don't believe it remains so, monsieur. For I filled it at the desire of a very high personage.
May I ask who this personage is, madame?
Her Majesty, the Empress Eugenie. I have the honor to be the governess of His Highness, the Prince Imperial.
Take it, madame.
I begin to see the folly of being the only one to do one's duty in a feeble-minded world.
Temperature is quite normal now.
Oh, thank God. I was right. The water is miraculous.
I'm sure it is, madame.
Lulu, my darling, you'll be well now, my sweet. Louis. Lulu is better. The water from Lourdes made him well.
Let us say, sire, the waters did the prince no harm. He had only a slight cold.
How can you say that? His forehead was on fire with fever.
Never more than 2 degrees, madam.
It was diphtheria or scarlet fever. I know it. I feel it.
Please, my dearest, don't excite yourself. Come and sit down.
Lulu has had a number of attacks like this, and he's always gotten well.
I tell you, Louis, it was the water that saved him.
That's a very frivolous observation, darling. You're doing a great injustice to the doctor's prescriptions.
You're an atheist, Louis.
That's the most stupid thing a sovereign could be.
Then you're worse than an atheist. You haven't the humility to thank God for the grace he's accorded us.
By order of His Majesty the Emperor, the ordinance of May 10th is hereby revoked and nullified as of this date. The grotto shall be opened. Signed, Louis Napoleon.
I must say, my dear Dean, your lady wastes no time in accepting a challenge.
The lady has had sweet revenge. I'm being transferred to L.A. Perhaps I should say demoted to L.A.
Yes, I rather expected you would be. I, too, received a letter this morning.
Yeah? What hole are you headed for?
In my case, the lady wanted even sweeter revenge. I am to stay here for a while at least. Watch the thing I fought against blossom like a fruit tree. It's the influenza again. I can feel it. Evidently, the lady intends to leave me exactly as she found me. Some hot wine, Dudo.
Oui, monsieur.
And then I ran to the other side and ate of the grass and the herbs as the lady had asked me to.
I can't understand the lady demanding anything so repulsive of you. It doesn't fit into the description that you gave of her, that she bade you act like an animal.
Do you act like an animal when you eat salad?
Go on.
Then I looked for the spring. Since I couldn't see it, I suppose the lady meant that it was below the ground. So I began to scratch and dig with my fingers.
Considered a miracle, a healing must be as sudden as a bolt of lightning. It must be from one moment to the next. Further proof is necessary.
Then I looked for the spring. Since I could not see it, I suppose the lady meant that it was below the ground. So I began to scratch and dig with my fingers. Then I looked for the spring. Since I could not see it, I suppose the lady meant that it was below the ground.
There is still the possibility of deception. Further proof is necessary. The evidence is insufficient.
Brother came in with a frostbitten nose.
Come on,
it needs to rub snow on it.
March is coming in like a lion, isn't it? Sit down, Bernadette.
Oh, thank you,
I'm sorry, I was unable to attend your sister's wedding on Thursday. Father poured me out, tells me it was lovely.
Oh, yes. We had lots of cakes. One with figures on it. It was ever so nice.
Now, I suppose she'll be giving up her position with Madame Millet.
Yes, they're going to live on a farm. But Madame Millet is going to take me as housemaid.
So I heard today. That's why I wanted to talk to you.
Oh, it's not hard work. And the pay is good. You know, it's strange, Your Reverence. The lady once told me I could never be happy in this world. But I am. Happier than I've ever been. I've got a position. And...
Monsieur Antoine is a splendid young man. Bernadette, have you any idea of what the Bishop's Commission has been doing?
Oh, yes. The gentlemen have examined and tested all the people who've been cured.
That's true. What of yourself? Don't you think that you and your case are part of their task also?
I've answered all the gentlemen's questions. I hope they won't ask me any more.
The commission is now engaged in writing a very important report about you. It admits the possibility that you were chosen by the powers above, and that your hand alone brought forth the spring responsible for miraculous cures. Don't you understand what that means?
No.
It means that the greatest and the wisest men in the church will be watching you for decades. Then, perhaps long after the rest of us are dead and thought of no more, you will...
Oh, but that's dreadful. I don't want it. It can't be.
It's no small matter.
No, no.
Tell me, aren't the sisters in the hospital and in the school good and kind?
Yes. Yes, they are. They're very sweet.
Could you imagine yourself as one of them someday?
Dear God, no, that's far above me. I just want to go and work for Madame Millet, his housemaid. Please.
My dear child. To you, the most blessed Virgin condescended. This places a responsibility on you. You can't suddenly play truant and run away from your destiny as though it was school and become an old widow's servant. A long time ago, I told you you were playing with fire, Bernadette. Your lady was heavenly fire. Heaven chose you. And now there's nothing left for you but to choose heaven. Isn't that true?
Yes.
You like the life with the sisters at Navarre. Their order is beautiful and lofty. Very much involved in practical life.
Everything you have said is true, Your Reverence. And I will do exactly as you say. But...
You're worried about your family? You needn't. You may stay with them until summer. It'll take that long before the report is fully complete. And I've arranged for your father to be established in the mill on the Upper Lapakar. There he can practice the trade for which he was meant. Your family can live without fear of poverty. No. Bernadette. Just one moment. I have something more to say. Although as a member of the commission, I shouldn't say it. Now, mind you, I have full faith in you. But there's always been one small detail which I never could help but doubt. It's the words Immaculate Conception. If you could ever admit that this phrase was not spoken by the lady, things might be very different. If you could retract this single incident, then there might be somewhere in this world a little corner where you could hide and lead a normal life. Would you like a little time to think it over?
I don't need time, Your Reverence, because I've never lied to you.
Did I speak of lying?
And I don't want a little corner to hide in. Good day, Your Reverence. Patron saint of travelers, watch over you.
The sea kiss her, that's what we gave her.
Two will make my journey doubly safe.
Go along, Junior. Go along.
Go on, Junior.
I don't want to say it. It sounds silly.
You owe your life to Bernadette. You say it exactly as I taught you.
You too.
Oh, Bernadette, if I live to be 100, I shall never forget this hour. For his junior-old statue from jaws of death made all mine here.
A St. Christopher? How thoughtful.
Well, 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 Bernadette.
I shall be only a moment.
I'm sorry to be late, but it was unavoidable. I was making a speech at the depot.
So my old and dear friend is leaving Lourdes. Bernadette, never will I forget those first days of trial and tribulation, when practically we alone stood side by side facing a doubting world. Always will I remember...
Pardon me, Your Honor, but the sisters in the carriage grow impatient.
Huh?
And I've not yet said goodbye to my family.
Oh.
Will you excuse me?
Oh, certainly, certainly. Here, this is merely something to enjoy on your journey.
Oh, thank you, Monsieur.
And this. May the ever-watching patron saint of travel hover over your carriage and guide you safely to your destination.
Thank you, Miss. I wanted to say goodbye in here. Keep well wrapped up. And remember that you... Memo, I don't need a shawl.
Nonsense. It'll be very windy with your asthma.
Please.
This is no time to talk about Charles. So much to say, and so little time to say it. But when the time comes, one can say nothing. One can only feel.
Goodbye, Papa.
Goodbye, my child.
Goodbye, Mama. Hi, Bernadette.
Say goodbye to Madame Nicolo and her son. Dear sisters, I know you've waited so long, but may I have another moment?
We must reach Toulouse before dark.
Oh, nothing can happen to us. Look, I have enough protection for even the horses.
Very well, but hurry.
I said goodbye once this morning, I know. But I have a little something for you. Don't worry, it's not a St. Christopher. You have only four. I blessed five this morning.
Someone must be late.
Bernadette, sometimes to express certain things in a letter is difficult. So wherever you may go, if ever you should need me, just send me this. I shall understand and come immediately.
Your Reverence, if only you knew how much this means to me.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, Bernadette, and God bless you.
Mademoiselle.
Monsieur, they are so beautiful.
I didn't come to say goodbye with the others because there was something I wanted to tell you.
What was it, Monsieur Antoine?
Well, I wanted to say, well, my mother is getting old. She and I are used to each other. We get along very well. So I've decided never to take a wife. Because a mother-in-law and a daughter-in-law, well, that doesn't work out so well. I'm going to stay unmarried, too. Well, that's what I wanted to say to you. Now I wish you luck on your journey, Bernadette.
You are the postulant from Lourdes?
Yes, Mother Superior.
What is your name?
Subaru. Bernadette Subaru.
How old are you?
Just past 20.
What can you do?
Oh, nothing that amounts to much.
In the world, what would you have liked to have been?
I always thought I could have been a good servant girl.
Is that your sister, Marie-Thérèse?
Yes, Mother Superior.
This is the mistress of the novices, to whose guidance you look from now on. This is Bernadette Subaru, a new postulant.
We know each other.
The postulant will start in the kitchen tomorrow. You will be asked to wash dishes, scrub floors, sweep corridors. In brief, do all the lowly tasks that need to be done. But please observe, I do not command you. I am merely proposing this. If you do not feel equal to it, or if such work is repellent to you, physically or spiritually, I wish you would say so now.
Oh, no, Mother Superior. I'm very happy to work in the kitchen.
Good. Sister Marie-Thérèse will show you to yourself.
With your permission, Mother Superior, there is one other matter to be considered. The postulant bears a name which has made a great noise in the world. But among us, great names have no meaning. Although they may have been acquired through far greater effort, we disassociate ourselves from all we may have meant to the world and all it has meant to us. Moreover, the name Bernadette is a childish and trivial diminutive.
Quite right. Before actually entering upon your novitiate, you will want to choose another name. Under the circumstances, it will be best to do so now. Have you given the matter any thought?
No, I haven't.
What was your godmother's name?
Bernard.
Then surely you'll be happy to bear the name of Mary Bernard, my child.
This way, Mary Bernard. The cell is not your liking, Mary Bernard.
Oh, yes, sister. It is quite to my liking.
You will learn to be comfortable in it. A convent is no prison. No force is exercised here. If you do not feel capable of our obedience, you will find the door is always open. Good night, Mary Bernard.
Good night, sister.
Mary Bernard.
Yes, sister?
What are you thinking about?
About my family.
Worldly remembrances have no place in this house. We're here for the purpose of concentration, not for reverie and wool gathering.
Yes, sister.
You find this work repellent?
Oh, no, sister.
Then let's show our willingness to serve God and not hesitate in our tasks.
Yes, sister.
Sister Mary Bernard is limping.
Yes, I've noticed it. I'm afraid it is a worldly desire to become the center of attention. I shall speak to her. Sister Mary Bernard, come here, please.
Yes, sister.
I wish to speak with you.
Certainly, sister. Would you have me finish prayers first?
What I have to say to you is just as important for your soul. We will speak in your cell.
Yes, sister.
Excuse me, Mother Superior. Sit down, Mary Bernard. I've been wanting to talk to you for a long time. Why do you limp?
Oh, it's nothing, sister.
Limping gained sympathy from the other sisters, is that it?
But I never...
You forget, I've known you for many years. In the outside world, you were celebrated. From all over France, people came just to gaze upon you. Here, you are a nonentity. You find that difficult to bear, don't you?
Oh, no.
The temptation to cling to your eminence is undoubtedly too strong for you.
Truly, sister. Never have I said or done anything to attract attention. I wish only to be one of the sisters here. Nothing more.
10 years ago, I was forced to doubt you. I have not changed.
I have never told you an untruth.
I have tried to believe you. Only God knows how hard I've tried. But I cannot.
What is it you don't believe?
What everyone else is willing to believe.
The lady? Oh, I did see her. I did.
Many agree with you. Even the Holy Father in Rome. But I do not. I cannot. What do you know of suffering?
Nothing.
In all our sacred history, the chosen ones have always been those who have suffered. Why then should God choose you? Why not me?
I cannot answer that.
I know what it is to suffer. Look at my eyes. They burn like the very fires of hell. Why? Because they need sleep. They need rest, which I will not give them. My throat is parched from constant prayer. My hands are gnarled from serving God in humiliation. My body is pain-wrecked from stone floors. Yes, I have suffered, because I know it is the only true road to heaven. And if I, who have tortured myself, cannot glimpse the Blessed Virgin, how can you, who have never felt pain, dare to say you have seen her?
I don't know why I was chosen. You are 100 times more worthy.
If only I could find evidence. If only you could give me some proof. Maybe then I could believe. Maybe then these monsters of doubt and hate would stop consuming my very soul. For the love of God, sister, give me some proof.
I wish I could help you. But I have never suffered. I have never... Perhaps I can help you. It may be there is proof for you.
Well, Doctor?
Well, in addition to the large tumor on the knee, she has tuberculosis of the bone. She has never complained of pain?
No. Has she? She never mentioned it.
I can't understand it. She's had this affliction for a long time. And the constant pain and suffering which is so characteristic of this disease is too horrible to describe.
I tried to storm the gates of heaven by sacrificing myself.
I know now that we must be chosen. That we must be graced as you have graced this child. God, forgive me. I have persecuted her and I did not believe her because I was filled with hate and envy. God, help me to serve this chosen soul for the rest of my days. God, help me. God, help me.
You seem a trifle stronger today, sister.
Yes, thank you, Mother Superior. I am.
Sister Mary Therese and I have been discussing the possibility of your taking a trip.
A trip?
We could make the journey to our convent of Lourdes in easy stages.
Lourdes?
Should not you, of all people, take advantage of the benefit that's come to the whole world through you?
That cannot be done.
And why not?
Spring is not for me.
Why should not the spring work in your case, of all cases, sister?
Spring is not for me.
Did the lady tell you that, my child?
She said, I cannot promise you happiness in this world, only in the next. Spring is not for me.
In that case, Father, we must notify the bishop immediately. He wants to hear from Mary Bernhardt's lips a final confirmation.
Sister Marie Bernard, we shall read to you the final protocol of the Commission of Investigation assembled in 1858. It contains a record of all the testimony which you offered at the time. We ask nothing of you except that you confirm that testimony. Do you feel equal to that?
I, Bernadette Soubirous, was sent in the company of my sister Marie and my friend Jeanne Abadie to fetch firewood in the forest.
Do you confirm this?
I did see her.
At a location known as Massabielle, I rested while my sister and friend crossed the River Gard.
Do you confirm this?
I did see her.
For a time, nothing happened. Then suddenly I noticed that the rose bush in the grotto was shaking. I thought this strange because there was no...
I did see her. I did see her. I...
sorry you came back to visit us.
No. 5 years I've been stationed in Languedoc. A stinking hole if ever there was one. Now that I see this, I realize what a paradise I've been living in.
You see, my friend, how deeply hell reaches into human life.
Poor ignorant sheep. Why do they come?
Because they have faith, because they're desperate, because occasionally someone is cured.
Because some hypochondriac, due to emotional excitement, forgets a malady that never existed.
Oh, yes, we have hundreds of those. But we have many, many other cases that aren't so easy to explain. Yesterday, there was a woman with lupus, tuberculosis of the face. Suddenly, she discovered a nose and a mouth. For only 10 minutes before, there was nothing but one large, decaying cavity.
Please, Doctor. I'm not a gullible sheepherder from the Pyrenees.
We have pictures in the office. Would you care to come down?
Gentlemen, what's the use? The same argument has been going on for a great many years. And I'm afraid will go on for a great many more. For those who believe in God, no explanation is necessary. For those who do not, no explanation will suffice.
Your Reverence.
Yes, Adelaide.
Here is a message. Your housekeeper thought it was important and asked me to bring it to you.
Thank you. This is the first. You remember him, the boo-hoo-hoo child?
Is that all, Your Reverence?
Yes, thank you, Adelaide.
You should have the doctor give you something for that cold, monsieur.
No. It's just a little laryngitis I picked up on the drafty train last night. It will be gone by tomorrow. Excuse me, gentlemen. Good day.
Good day,
Good day, Dean.
I give you full permission, dear doctor, to write down in your big book my amazing recovery was due solely to the Lady of Lourdes.
If I kept such a book, I would write you down merely as a skeptic, who I promise will leave Lourdes at least wondering.
Not I, doctor. Not I. This place only succeeds in revolting me. Once it was a dull but pleasing little village. Now look at it. A tremendous sponge sopping up all the infection.
Good morning, Mr. Jones.
Dr. Drusel.
Good day, gentlemen.
Good day, Monsieur
Doctor. Good day, Monsieur.
You look better today.
Oh, yes, Doctor. I think I feel much better today, thank you.
Monsieur Jones' voice has a lot in common with Monsieur Dutour's. Don't you think?
Yes, now that you mention it.
Monsieur Jones has cancer of the larynx.
Reverence.
my child.
I didn't lie to you.
God knows you didn't.
They questioned me again and again. I saw her. Tell them I saw her. They won't believe me.
Yes, my little one, you saw her. And you will see her again.
I'm not so sure. Maybe I haven't suffered enough.
You've suffered enough, my child, for the heaven of heavens.
Oh, no. I know about sick people. We all exaggerate a little. Our pains aren't so terrible. I believe. Sister. Sister.
Are the pains worse?
What day is this?
Wednesday.
Wednesday? Thursday. The lady. Madame. Madame. I didn't even know what the Holy Trinity was. Where are you, Madame? Where are you? She's gone.
Behold, my beloved, speak it to me. Arise, make haste, my love, my dove, my beautiful one.
I won't see her.
For winter is now past, the rain is over and gone.
I'll never see her again. Never.
Arise, my love, my beautiful one.
Never.
My dove in the clefts of the rock, in the hollow places
I'll
of the
I'll never see.
Show me thy face. Let thy voice sound in my ears. For thy voice is sweet.
Heaven and on earth. Your life begins, O Bernadette.